Hello and welcome. My name is Debora Santo and I'm thrilled to present to you the latest advancements in the Typhoon HIL Control Center 2024.3 software release. Today, we will explore the new features and improvements designed to enhance your simulation and testing capabilities. Let's start with the software support for our new HIL101 device. The HIL101 features 16 analog inputs, 16 analog outputs, 32 digital inputs, and 32 digital outputs. It supports up to 3 standard processing cores and offers the same communication capabilities as our HIL404 device. For a deeper dive into the capabilities and applications of the HIL101 device, I highly recommend watching our webinar titled From Offline to Hardware-in-the-Loop Simulation Seamlessly, Introducing Typhoon Sim and HIL101, that is linked in the video description below. In this webinar, we cover the transition from offline to real-time hardware-in-the-loop simulations, demonstrating how the HIL101 can be seamlessly integrated into a unified model-based digital engineering workflow. The webinar is a valuable resource for understanding the full potential of the HIL101 device, showcasing its ease of use and flexibility in various educational and research scenarios. You can access the features of HIL101 by navigating to the Model Settings option and then looking at the device table. This specific section provides detailed insights into the device configurations and settings, so you can maximize the utility of the HIL101 capabilities. The motivation behind the development of the HIL101 was to offer an accessible yet powerful entry-level device for educational and basic industrial applications. It addresses the need for a comprehensive solution without compromising performance, making it ideal for universities and training centers that require advanced tools for teaching and research. Next, we introduce support for the HIL506 device. The HIL506 boasts 16 analog inputs, 32 analog outputs, 32 digital inputs, and 32 digital outputs. It supports up to 6 standard processing cores and is capable of handling simulation steps as low as 200 nanoseconds for general circuits and 25 nanoseconds for DC-DC solver simulations. One of the standout features for the HIL506 is its ability to be connected in parallel with HIL606, making the first time we offer cross-device paralleling. This capability significantly expands the possibilities for creating HIL setups, allowing for greater flexibility and scalability in your simulation projects. To access the features of the HIL506, navigate to the Model Settings option and look at the device table. This section provides detailed insights into the device configuration and settings, ensuring you can fully leverage the capabilities of the device. The HIL506 is engineered to offer a versatile and affordable solution without sacrificing performance, seamlessly bridging the gap between our entry-level and high-end devices. This mid-range device is designed to meet the needs of various applications, while also offering the possibility for more variety and flexibility in your HIL setups. A significant enhancement in this release is the support for unconstrained signal processing execution rates. This update provides greater flexibility in your simulations by removing previous limitations on execution rates, thereby significantly enhancing the fidelity of software-in-the-loop simulations. Previously, execution rates were required to be integer multiples of the simulation time step. However, with this release, execution rates can now be set to any value, allowing for more precise control and improved accuracy in software-in-the-loop simulations. This enhancement is particularly beneficial for control algorithms that operate at non-standard rates, providing a more accurate representation of real-world systems. To change execution rates, navigate to the property of a signal processing component in the schematic editor. Additionally, you can observe the applied execution rate slots on the CPU in the time slot monitor in HIL SCADA. This tool provides a visual representation of how the execution rates are allocated, allowing you to monitor and optimize the performance of your simulations. The motivation behind this update was to accommodate a wider range of control systems, ensuring that simulations can closely match real-world timing requirements and deliver the highest fidelity possible. In this release, we have enabled help support for library widgets in HIL SCADA. The new help button in the widget property dialog provides instant access to documentation. For core widgets, this brings up predefined documentation, while the custom library widgets allow for user-defined documentation. You can specify the help file path for custom library widgets in the documentation tab, where documentation supports both HTML and PDF formats. Additionally, the Library Explorer now includes a help context menu action. Right-click on any widget and select Help to access its documentation. These improvements ensure you have quick access to relevant information, streamlining your overall workflow. Among the communication interface updates, we have added the EtherCAT Master component. Now, with the EtherCAT Master, you are allowed to have a seamless interface between the HIL device and multiple EtherCAT slave devices. To access the component, go to the Communication tab in the Library Explorer. As we can see, the flexible Ethernet port selection is available here. Below, we can define the cycle time, which is the sending period of the EtherCAT master. In the bottom part of the component property window, we can add or remove slave devices. We can add multiple slave devices, where the number of slave devices must match the number of slave devices on the network. To define the slave device, we need to choose and import an ESI file from our computer. Once loaded, we can observe information about the slave device, such as vendor information and the contents of its process data objects. Finally, we can also choose to reprogram the slave device directly from the master on its model load. We do this by importing its binary file. With the addition of the EtherCAT master component, we are providing more flexibility to real-time control applications in domains such as renewable energy systems and smart grid applications, among others. We have also made some enhancements to the Modbus server by adding a pipelining feature, which allows the Modbus server to handle multiple requests simultaneously. This feature stores requests in a buffer until their execution, significantly reducing latency and improving performance. This update is particularly useful for systems with heavy Modbus communication demands, such as microgrid controllers, SCADA systems, and industrial networks. In this release, we have made some further enhancements to our absolute encoder protocols. Let us open the feedback tab of an induction machine component to check out these updates. Previously, the encoder data length was limited to 16 bits, but now you can use different encoder data lengths to suit your specific needs. We have also added the option to specify the number of multi-turn bits, providing more detailed and accurate tracking. These enhancements are available for NDAT, BIS, and SSI protocols, ensuring that your system can handle a variety of encoder configurations with improved flexibility and precision. We conclude with an example of differential protection, commonly referred to as NC87. It demonstrates the implementation of a percentage differential protection function with an unrestrained element. This example was developed by the Santa Maria Technical and Industrial School of the Federal University of Santa Maria. This example serves as a ready-to-use template for implementing differential protection in your projects. You can find it in the Examples Explorer. It is particularly relevant for power system protection and testing, showcasing the efficacy in detecting and isolating faults to safeguard electrical equipment and ensure system reliability. For a more detailed exploration of the topic and demo of the model, visit the HIL Simulation for Power System Protection course on the HIL Academy learning platform, also developed by UFSM, as well as the application note of the example. For easy access, we have provided the links to these resources in the video description below. Additionally, if your industry or research group is developing examples that would benefit from being featured via our channels, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. Thank you for joining us on this detailed walkthrough of the new developments with Typhoon HIL Control Center 2024.3 software release. We trust that these new features and improvements will significantly enhance your projects and research. Your feedback is of great value to us, so please share your thoughts and suggestions in the comments below. We are inviting you to subscribe to our channel and stay tuned for our upcoming updates.
Check the video description for more resources on this topic, including how to download and get started with Typhoon HIL Control Center for free. You can also visit HIL.academy to access free courses, expand your HIL testing skill set, and get certified. Subscribe to our channel to get notified about new content.